Creepers, it's Jacqueline Frost. Today we are going to be reviewing the Jacqueline Hill Palette Volume 2. Look at those colors. So I've already done pretty much my face, except for the eyes. So, the great thing about this palette is usually when you get the Morphe palettes, comes with the plastic that has the labels of all the eyeshadows. Jacqueline's palette has the names on the palette itself. So you actually can look to see what you're dipping into. I can't see without my glasses on, so I don't know what I'm dipping into. I just see color. So we're gonna get started. Today I'm going to do kind of a bigger look. I've already got my red lip on, so I want to do something bigger with the eyes, because today we're also bringing out Big Bertha. That is some hair. So we need to we're going big. Go big or go home. So we're going to go in first, and I'm going to do the crease. Probably put my glasses on for this part. We'll do the crease with Empowered. That is Empowered. I also normally don't go down my eyebrows, but since I'm going with a bigger wig today, I decided to glue down my eyebrows and then draw mine on. And you can tell, I've not done it in a while. So, the reason why I am doing all of this is because me and a friend of mine have a weekly talk show that we are launching. It will be on Facebook Live. You can go to Facebook, and the group is Stay Fabulous. And it's with Kaylin Fierce and Jacqueline Frost. So check us out on Facebook. Probably by the time this gets posted, our first official show will be next week. It'll be Sunday nights at 7 p.m. And it'll be starting in August. She's actually coming here for a visit. So we're going to do our first show together. And then the other shows following will be her in Ohio and me in Michigan. That's Empowered. I think what I'm gonna do too is take it a little up. This is the Jacqueline Hill Volume 2. I did get the Jacqueline Hill Volume 1. It was the first one I got. That one was this one. And the colors on here are more of autumn type colors. I did like an Aztec eye with a couple of these, and it turned out really good. And when I saw she had the Volume 2 palette, I'm like, well, I love the Volume 1. So let's go with the Volume 2 and see what she's got. And I gotta say, I'm loving it. So for under the eye, I want something that's gonna pop a little bit, like just. So I'm gonna go in with. So we're gonna go in. I can see it. No Joke, which is our yellow. And I'm just gonna go under the eye. If it's really popping or not. I'm also going to take some in the corner too. So it's a little bit of a pop there. I think in the corners, going with something a little bit darker, just like under and then in the corner. So I'm going to use the Stay True. Also makes the yellow underneath pop a little bit more. There's that. I think underneath, I'm going to go with this one. It's called Paolo. I'm gonna do the lid. I'm going to go back with that yellow. Kind of pull it out more. There we go. It's like Bob Ross. Just going to put in a pretty little tree over here. Crayola calls it black. I'm Trixie Cosmetics blush. I showed you this one before. That's what it looks like. With my eyebrows, I normally use an eyebrow powder. I'm going to go in the palette to do a touch-up, but I think I'm going to brighten up the ends. So I'm going to go in on the eyebrows with Homebody. Just because since I'm wearing a blonde wig, this will lighten up the darker eyebrows. And I just want you to know that I'm making this up as I go. I've never used an eyeshadow for an eyebrow before. But we're going to see how this works. Not bad. It also kind of brightens up the face. So let's go in with some more yellow. And just draw it out a little bit more. And I'll be back with the final look. Ta-da! Thanks for watching today's video. Make sure to like, subscribe, and to ring the notification bell for more. Videos. Bye.